Hello, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we're gonna discuss about one more transformation, which is derived column transformation. So derived column transformation is very important transformation because here we can apply the expressions according to our business requirement. So let's start with derived column transformation. So what is derived column transformation? So basically it is used to create a new column values or replace existing column values by applying expressions. So what is expression? So an expression can contain any combination of variables, functions and columns from transformation input. For example, if we are getting data from SQL Server table and we want to apply few formula to manipulate the input, then we can use derived column transformation by which we can manipulate our input data. It also has an option to concatenate data from different columns. Like if you are getting the data like first name and last name, and we want to concatenate first name and last name to get the full name. So by using this transformation, we can achieve this. So we have few examples over here. As we can see, we have an input table and it has few columns. So in our first condition, we want to concatenate first name and last name. So we can do this. Second, if we want to get the only first character from first name, then also we can do this. If we want to apply round function inside the salary column and we want to only two digit after decimal place, so we can do this. If we want to extract only year from date of birth, then we can also do this. So how we can do this? So let's start. So this is our table. As we can see, it has four rows we have displayed in our slide. So let's move to SSDT. So here we need to add one more package. Right click on this SSIS package and add a new SSIS package and rename with derived column. So this is for derived column transformation. So first of all, we have to use a data flow task. And inside this data flow task, we have to configure our source. So our source is SQL Server table. So we have to use OLEDB source. Now we need to configure OLEDB source. Here we need to specify the connection manager. So click on new. As we have created the connection, so I'm going to use this one. Click on OK. Here we need to select the table. So this is our table. We can select and go to on columns. So we want all the columns. Click on OK. So we have done our source part. Now we need to use derived column. So this is our derived column transformation. So we can drag and drop. As we can see over here, it has fx. So we can use expressions. So double click on this derived column and go to on columns. So first of all, we want to concatenate first name and last name, as we can see over here. So first name, then last name. So we can drag and drop this first name inside this expression. So this is our first name. Then we need to specify plus symbol, and then we want one space, then again concatenate symbol, then last name. So we can drag and drop this last name, and we can rename this with full name. This is our full name. As we can see, derived column. Inside this derived column, we have drop down. What we want? We want to add a new column or we want to replace our existing column. So we want to add a new column for this. So choose our first option. So we have done our first part. Now in our second condition, we want to get only first character from first name. So drag and drop this first name inside the expression. Then we need to write substring. So this is our substring, and we want only first character. So we have to specify one and one. So we can close the bracket. So we have done our second part, and this is for first character from first name. So our next is, we want around the salary. So drag and drop this salary column inside the expression, and we have to use round. So we can specify round comma 2, because we want around only 2 decimal places. So we have done our third, and this is for round salary. So our next is, we want to extract year part from date of birth. So we need to drag and drop date of birth this time, and so here we need to use date part function. So date part, then we need to specify what we want to extract. We want to extract year, so we have to specify year, then close the bracket. So this is for year. So we have done all these. So now I am going to use multicast. I'll explain multicast in upcoming videos. For this time, I am not going to load this data into any table or any flat file. I am just going to populate this data by using enable data viewer. It will pause this package and display the data. So now I am going to execute this package. So once we execute this package, then we can see package is paused between these two tasks because data viewer is enabled between them. So as we can see, we have full name, then first character from first name, then round salary, and then year. So we are getting the data as we were expected. So we have done all these 4 examples. Now, as we can see, I have explained this. So here we can see, we can also use if else condition, like if the month name is equal to 1, then we want to display Jan. If the month name is equal to 2, then we want to Feb. If this value not be satisfied, then we want to December. So this is our if, then again if, then else. So we can use if else condition inside our dragged column. So how we can achieve this? We can, now I'm going to delete this one and going to add one more column. So I am going to use for employee ID. If the employee ID is less or equal to 2, then we have to use question mark and we need to specify low. Then again colon, and we have to specify our employee ID less or equal to 3, then we want to display medium, else we want to display large. So this is our if and else condition. Now we can check. Again, I am going to use multicast and going to connect. Here we need to enable our data viewer. Now I am going to execute. As we can see, last column has been added successfully. So for ID 1 and 2, we are getting low. For ID 3, we are getting medium. For ID 4, we are getting large. So we can use if and else condition as well. We can also replace null values by using if else condition, as we have discussed over here, or we have a replace null formula by which we can directly replace the null values. Now I'm going to drop. I'm going to add one more column, and this time if the null value is present in this department name, then we want to replace that value. So this is the function which is available inside this editor. If we need, then we can use. So go to on null function. So we have replace null, so we can use it. Replace null, then if the null value is present in this department name, then we want to display NA. So now I am going to again enable data viewer. So as of now, we can see we have the null value in department name if the employee ID is 3. So now I am going to execute this package. So null value should be replaced by NA. So for this column, as we can see, null value has been replaced by NA. So we can use it if we need it. So we have a lab assignment for you. Check if null and divide by zero values are available. If available, then replaced by 0.00. And formula for this lab assignment will be available on the description of this video. If you need, then you can copy from there. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos.